I wondered if you might make it here. You're quite resourceful. I'm known as Father. The Institute is under my guidance. I know why you're here. I'd like to discuss things with you face to face. Please, step into the elevator. I can only imagine what you've heard, what you think of us. I'd like to show you that you may have the wrong impression. Welcome to the Institute. This is the reality of the Institute. This place, these people, the work we do. For over 100 years, we've dedicated ourselves to humanity's survival. Decades of research, countless experiments and trials, a shared vision of how science can help shape the future. It has never been easy. And our actions are often misinterpreted by those above ground. Someday, perhaps, we can show them what we've accomplished. But for now, we must remain underground. There's too much at stake here to risk it all. As you've seen, things above are unstable. I'd like to talk to you about what we can do for everyone. But that can wait. You are here for a specific, very personal reason. You are here for your son.
Sean?
Huh? Yes, I'm Sean.
Sean? Is that really you?
Who are you?
Sean, it's me. I'm your dad.
Father, what's going on? What's happening?
Yes.
What's going on?
It's me.
Father?
Your dad.
Father!
I'm here, Sean. Sean, open the door!
I don't know you! Go away! Father! Father, help me! There's someone here! Help me!
Please, Sean! I'm your father! Talk to me! Just open the door!
Father! Father, help me! He's trying to take me! Father! Father, help me!
Sean. S923, recall code Cirrus. Fascinating, but disappointing. The child's responses were not at all what I anticipated. He's a prototype, you understand. We're only just now beginning to explore the effects of extreme emotional stimuli. Please try and keep an open mind. I recognize that you are emotional, and that your journey here has been fraught with challenges. Let's start anew.
Give me Sean! The real Sean! Right now!
I know. I know. You've gone to such lengths to find him.
God. All we're missing are the teacups and the white rabbit.
Ah, levity. Excellent. A sure sign that you adapt quickly to stressful environments. But I need you to realize that this situation is far more complicated than you could have imagined. You have traveled very far, and suffered a great deal to find your son. Well, your tenacity and dedication have been rewarded. It's good to finally meet you, after all this time. It's me. I am Sean. I am your son.
How is that even possible?
I know this is a lot to take in. In the vault, you had no concept of the passage of time. You were released from your pod and went searching for the sun you'd lost. But then you learned that your son was no longer an infant, but a 10-year-old boy. You believed that 10 years had passed. Is it really so hard to accept that it was not 10, but 60 years? That is the reality, and here I am. Raised by the Institute, and now its leader.
They stole you. Kidnapped you. Wasn't right.
Right, wrong, irrelevant. It was necessary. The Institute believed humanity's future depended on it. At that time, the year 2227, the Institute had made great strides in synth production. But it was never enough. Scientific curiosity and the goal of perfection drove them ever onward. What they wanted was the perfect machine. So they followed the best example thus far. The human being. Walking, talking, fully articulate, capable of anything.
So the weird science experiments needed specimens. That's why they took you.
In a manner of speaking, yes. The Institute endeavored to create synthetic organics. The most logical starting point, of course, was human DNA. Plenty of that was available, of course. But it had all become corrupted. In this wasteland, radiation affected everyone. Even in their attempts to shield themselves from the world above, members of the Institute had been exposed. Another source was necessary. But then the Institute found me. After discovering records from Vault 111, an infant, frozen in time, protected from the radiation-induced mutations that had crept into every other human cell in the Commonwealth. I was exactly what they needed. And so it was my DNA that became the basis of the synthetic organics used to create every human-like synth you see today. I am their father. Through science, we are family. The synths, me, and you.
I don't believe you. There's no way any of this is true. I don't believe you.
I wish there was something to say. I know this isn't what you wanted. But it's the only truth I can offer you.
You're my son? Then prove it. Now.
I've already told you how I came to be here. I don't know what further proof I can offer that would convince you. I've shown you my trust. Your weapons haven't been confiscated. And I stand unarmed before you. Please, let's just talk.
If this is true, where do we start?
I know you must have questions. Please, anything I can do to help you understand.
Your mother. She never got to see you grow up?
Yes. What happened to her was... I've gone over the records of the incident, of course. It seems her death was an unfortunate bit of collateral damage.
Collateral damage? Is that all she was to you?
I forget that it's been such a short time for you. I don't have any direct memories. And I've had my entire life to cope with the loss. Has it always been easy? Of course not. But I've done my best to move on and live my life. For many years, I never questioned who my parents were. I accepted my situation, and that was that. With old age comes regret, and asking what if more often. But what matters now is that you and I have a chance to begin again. What else can I say to ease your mind?
So you're in charge of the Institute?
I am the acting director, yes. I spent decades working to reach this point. It's a responsibility I take very seriously. The Institute. It's important. It really is humanity's best hope for the future, no matter what those above ground might think of us.
But, Director? Why you?
I was the most qualified for the position. Obviously. I've lived my life within these walls. Dedicated to science like every other member of the Institute. My hard work has paid off. Ultimately, the Commonwealth has nothing to fear from us. Whatever you've seen or heard, I know I can convince you of that. Just give me time. What else can I say to ease your mind?
Kellogg. He worked for you?
Kellogg. He was an Institute asset long before I arrived here. It wasn't until I became director that I learned of all the things he'd done. What kind of man he was.
You knew the man was a psychopath, but you used him anyway?
Would you have preferred that I turned him loose on the Commonwealth? At least keeping him on a short leash kept the collateral damage to a minimum. The Institute took advantage of Kellogg's vicious nature. I will freely admit that. Institute technology prolonged his life, and his usefulness far beyond any normal human lifespan. He never failed the Institute, but his cruelty became more apparent with every completed objective. I won't lie. It's no coincidence your path crossed his. It seemed a fitting way to allow you, us, to have some amount of revenge. I know there's more for us to discuss, but the Institute is on the verge of some important breakthroughs. Your presence would be appreciated as we approach them. I've been a part of something amazing here. I've helped to build a life for myself and the people of the Institute. And now, after all these years, you have an opportunity to help with that. Doesn't that intrigue you? Isn't that what you want?
Maybe. I don't know. This is so much to take in.
I know. And I am sorry. You have been through so much in such a short time. The Institute can provide a better life than anything above ground. You've been in the Commonwealth. You've seen what it's like. I assure you that you are better off with us.
Your Institute has done some horrible things.
Yes, well, the world is not what it used to be. What about the people you've aided in order to get here? What atrocities have they committed? The Brotherhood of Steel. They believe they're the only ones fit to control technology and destroy anyone who opposes them. And you would side with them. None have any true claim to nobility in this world. Those days are gone. But we are not the monsters we have been cast at. I simply ask that you give the Institute, me, a chance. A chance to show you what I've been telling you. We really do have humanity's best interest at heart. Will you take that chance?
All right.
Thank you. The Institute is now your home, as much as it is mine. Please take some time, get to know it. Meet the people you'll be working with. You'll want to introduce yourself to the division heads. Dr. Fillmore in Facilities. Dr. Ayo in SRB. Dr. Holdren in Bioscience. And finally, Dr. Lee in Advanced Systems. They've all been notified of your arrival, of course. Meet them, and then we'll discuss what comes next. Thank you.
say why?
He mentioned something about studying and then said a lot of scientific words, but I don't think he
It's an honor to have you here, sir.
Is it true Food Supplement 77 has been discontinued?
That is correct.
That was my favorite one. Can't we keep you here? Glad you made it.
I'll be happy to forward your request to the bioscience.
It must make you proud to see all that Father has done. Free to enjoy all that he has brought.
She's been at it for over 2 hours. What is she even testing?
Father has accomplished so much. I hope you can appreciate his work as we do.
Nothing.
I used
at
to
this
work
point,
exclusively
she's just doing it for fun.
Projects, but lately I prefer less animated.
Hey, Doc.
Since you're new here,
You should take time to learn our safety procedures.
Well, that was productive. If you ask me, we're only scratching the surface with the latest synths.
Excuse me, Doctor?
Ah, it's you. You're here then. Yes, yes, I know who you are. We all do. While I'm sure Father is very happy that you're here, I do hope it doesn't interrupt our work.
What is it you're working on?
Advanced systems, special projects. You've seen the boy, synth, already. We've been hard at work on him for quite a while now. Oh, before I forget, let me see that Pip-Boy of yours. I've been told to install a Courser chip in it for you. Father's orders. You're to be given full access, with the ability to relay in and out of the Institute at will.
Thank you. I'm sure that'll come in handy.
Given that the relay is the only way to access the Institute, handy is something of an understatement. In case the significance is lost on you, you'll be the only one here with that kind of access. If nothing else, it should demonstrate the amount of trust Father has placed in you. Now, unless there's something else, I really do need to get back to work.
I'd like a progress report on your division, if you don't mind.
Taking your new appointment in stride, I see. Very well. We've shifted resources off of other projects, like the Child Synth, to focus on Phase 3. I'm hoping that the above-ground efforts are successful. I understand those depend heavily on you.
Personnel only.
So Dr. Ayo thinks he can hide in his office, does he? Well, you can tell him that I intend to speak to Father about these unannounced security sweeps of yours. Ransacking my quarters in the middle of the night is totally unacceptable.
I'll pass along your message, Doctor.
See that you do.
Excuse me, Doctor.
Welcome, welcome. It is so good to meet you. I truly hope you come to think of the Institute as your home.
I hope I'll prove a useful test subject for you, Doctor.
What do you do here?
Oh, I'm in charge of housing and provisions. It's my mission to ensure that everyone lives a comfortable and productive life. You should know that many of us consider it a great honor to have you here.
Operating at full capacity.
I'm seriously thinking of heading over to robotics to knock some heads together.
What now?
They're dragging their feet on the
target. We're all looking forward to working with you.
Maybe I should take some courses with me. You know, send a message.
Please don't. There's enough friction as it is between us and pretty much all the other departments.
Justin Ayo, acting director of the Synth Retention Bureau. I'll be up front with you. We're going to be keeping a close eye on you for the near future. Despite your relation to Father, you're a bit of an unknown quantity. I'm sure you understand. There won't be any issues, will there?
No problems here.
Good to hear. Now, Father has asked that I provide you with a brief overview of the Synth Retention Bureau. Our primary responsibility is the recovery of escaped synths that are hiding among the human population on the surface.
So basically, you're the secret police.
Secret police? If that's a pre-war reference, then I'm afraid it's lost on me. Our main instrument is the Courser. A third-generation synth assigned to operate on the surface. Coursers hunt down and reclaim synths that have escaped the Institute. They are highly self-sufficient, trained in combat, infiltration, and tracking. In a word, our coursers are relentless. Well, I gather you know all this, since you've encountered one already. In fact, I'd very much like to know how you defeated it.
I'm no stranger to combat.
Even so, a courser should be more than a match for any single combatant. I suppose I'll have to ask robotics to perform detailed diagnostics on the entire production run. As if we don't have enough problems. Now, unless you need something else, I'll get back to work.
I'm good for now. Thanks.
Very well.
Must make you proud to see all that Father has
almost
done.
All that just need to tighten up this primary drive servo.
That's a third primary drive breakdown.
Duh.
Oh,
they weren't kidding.
I don't know.
You really are here.
Most of them have lasted past their projected lifespans.
I'm Allie. Allie Fillmore.
You ask me.
You can think of me as the Institute's chief engineer. When Father told us about you, I could hardly believe it. You've been through so much. I think most people would have just given up. If you don't mind my asking, what was it that kept you going all that time?
I wanted to kill the son of a bitch who murdered my wife.
Kellogg always was a cold bastard. If you ask me, we're better off without him. Now, I'll give you a quick rundown of the facilities division, and then I'll answer any questions you might have afterward. As you might guess, we keep the Institute's mechanical and electrical systems running smoothly. We maintain and upgrade all of the systems that make it possible to live and work in a place like this. There's a lot of machinery behind these walls that recycles the air and water and provides power to the laboratories and quarters. The work we do might not be as exciting as some of the other departments, but it's at least as important. So, now that you're here and you've spoken to Father, does that mean you're on board?
I'm not on board with anything.
No? And yet here you are, poking around. One might find that suspicious. If you're not planning on staying, I'd recommend keeping your hands to yourself. Wouldn't want to give the impression you're up to something. And consider having another talk with Sean. He really is anxious to have you with us. If there's anything else you'd like to know about the facilities division, I'm happy to discuss it.
I'm good for now. Thanks.
Goodbye, then. I can't argue with that. Even so, I'm ready to see the full Gen 3.
Just as you gave life to Father, he gave life to me.
Been reviewing Father's plans to expand our
Excuse me,
Doctor. I wonder how the Warwick family is doing. So good to have you here.
Young Wally must
Dr.
be close
Clayton
to 10
Holden,
years old by now.
Head of the bioscience.
It's remarkable that any child can survive for so long.
I can't wait for you to see the work we're
there,
doing.
Don't you think?
It's truly amazing.
Like what?
I was just about to explain that. As the name implies, the bioscience division specializes in fields of study such as botany, genetics, and medicine. Our most important directive is to ensure the health and well-being of everyone in the Institute. To that end, we cultivate highly specialized breeds of flora for use in food and medicine. We've even started to explore the idea of synthetic animal life. You probably saw the gorillas. They're really just a pet project at this point, but the potential is exciting nonetheless.
Yeah, I can't imagine anything more exciting than fake gorillas.
Speaking only for myself, I find them fascinating. Of course, I might be a little biased. I'm sure I've taken up enough of your time as it is, but I have to ask, have you decided whether you'll join us?
I'm an outsider. Would there even be a place for me here?
Even if science isn't your passion, there are plenty of ways to contribute. Our projects sometimes require an agent who can work on the surface to observe and gather information. From what I've heard, you're both fearless and resourceful. I think you'd be ideal for that kind of role. In any case, I imagine you'll want to continue looking around. Or, if you prefer, I'd be happy to answer any questions you might have.
You mentioned medical care.
I might need that from time to time.
In that case, you'll want to introduce yourself to Dr. Dean Volkert. He's our top biologist and also serves as the Institute's resident physician. Dr. Volkert works in the infirmary. Just pay him a visit whenever you need to. You won't find better medical care anywhere else in the Commonwealth. I'll promise you that.
Dr. Watson can be a little obsessive when it comes to rules and policies.
Director Holdren seems very taken with you.
Here's that holotape you gave me, full of Institute data. I hope.
Well, all right. I'll start digging into this and see if I can make any details.
What do you hope to find?
Whatever the Institute doesn't want anybody to know. All the good stuff on here is going to be encrypted. But the first job is to see if I can crack it. After that, well, I'll have to see what I've got. There's no telling what we might have grabbed off their mainframe.
Sure. Let's go.
Will do.
This better be an emergency.
Yeah. Take a look at me, Doc.
Go over your symptoms with me.
Too much radiation. I feel sick.
We'll clean you up. Don't worry. And that's that. Anything else bothering you?
No other complaints.
Take better care of yourself in the future, okay?
Hey, I'll be right back.
Don't let down the home team. Buy a spotter. The latest hairstyle. From the...
Look at this place.
Hey.
everyone in the Commonwealth will know.
We've got run some power to the transmitter. We need to focus on taking the castle back. Hey there. We need to focus on taking the capital.